Hi guys, Keith here, how you doing? Papa K from Big Tom the Vaping Crew. Not done a review for a while, so go do one now. Anyway, Vapour Boutique in Sheffield or in Nottingham sell the Orchid version 4. This is the version 4 of the Orchid. It's a cracking tank design. It's basically, I'll show you in the close-up, they'll show you the deck. I'm actually going to show you how that, not really making the coils, but how I wick the cotton into it, because a lot of people do complain that the Orchids, they either leak or they're getting dry hits. Now the way that I do the cotton wick is, I almost, way to describe it, it's like a mullet. Nice and fluffy on top with a little tail coming down into the juice channel, and I get no issues with wicking at all. Watch. I mean, vapor production is fantastic from the, you know, it's a tank, but it's brilliant. Can't beat that. You know, your K-Fun can't beat that, your El Cronigans, your Squapes. The version 1. Where's the version 1? Can't find it. Ah, there's the version 1, something like that. There you go. That's the version 1.1, that one. And that's the version 4. As you can see, there's quite a difference in height between them. This takes 2 mils more than the version 1, so there's a bit more juice capacity here, and it is very K-Fun-esque styled compared to the original Orchid, which is actually based on the, you know, the proper EtherTech Orchid. Yeah, so what we'll do is I'll build one for you, show you how I wick it, and then come back. So, catch you in a minute. See ya. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to put a couple of coils in this as I set my deck up. I'm going to use 28 gauge canthal wire. I'll do 8 wraps on each. So 8 wraps into the Orchid version 4. Now I've got an Orchid version 4 as well, which I've set up with 8 wraps of 0.4, and that worked out at 0.5 ohms, which was just a nice cloud chucking build on the Orchid. Okay, 2 mil bit. Let's say 2.5 mil bit actually on the jig. Yep, here we go. We'll unscrew this. Pop it in. There we go. Alright. Alright, so I'll do my two coils for the Orchid. There we go. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. There we go. Oops, spring back. There we go. 8 wraps of 28 gauge canthal. Do the same with this one. Here we go. Lock it in place. Right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Ding. Springy, springy. I'll tidy them up. Once I've got them on my mod, I'll tidy them up and get them all sorted. There we go. There we go. All done. Right. Got two coils there. first things first. Now with, you can see that. Focus that up. There we go. Can you see the little holes? What I'm going to do is I'm going to feed the wire into the negative post, and then the second hole of the positive, so it actually sits, so the coil actually sits over the airflow hole. There we go, push that through. You see it's sort of over the hole. I'll tidy it up, but that's it over the hole. And I'll do exactly the same with the second coil and get them all tidied up. But I'm going to pause it just now, put the top of the coils in. The most important part with the Orchid is actually how you wick it. Putting the coils in is easy, but actually the difficult part is wicking it properly so it doesn't leak and you don't get dry hits. So we're back 2 seconds with showing you how to wick it. Alright, here we go. Right, I've got the second, sorry, I've put the first coil in, as you can see, it's in place, and it's working out at 1.62 ohms at 28 gauge Canthal 8 wraps. I'm going to do exactly the same on the second side, and hopefully I should get a result of 0.8 ohms resistance. And you can see, single. Alright. It's sitting over the air hole. Sitting directly over the air hole. Okay, so I will now do the second coil and show you that. As you can see, I've now got both coils in and it is bang on 0.80 resistance. I've all tidied the wires up, don't worry. There you go, here's your dual coils on the Orchid V4 deck. Alright, now I'll tidy that up. Make sure they're firing properly and then we'll wick it. Okay, back in a tick. Right. Got the golden box here, I'm at 19 watts just so I can bed the coils in. Fire that up, let's see. They're heating very well together. Okay, that's it. And that is 0.8 ohm resistance on the Orchid V4. There we go. Right, what we'll do now is I'll show you how to wick up the Orchid. Okay, I've got a couple of pieces of organic cottons about, oh, I don't know, 2 inches long. What I'm going to do is I'm going to feed them into the Orchid and then show you how to cut them so that they wick properly into the juice channels. So the first one. Getting nice and tight so that you can feed it through the coil. Give it a nice twist. Twist it as you feed it. Okay, twist it as you feed it. You don't want it too tight, you want it, let's see, just a little bit of resistance on the coil. That's perfect. There we go. Just a little bit of resistance. How's that? We'll do the same with the other side. Doing it this way, I've had no issues with wicking or leaking, which the Orchids have got a bad habit of doing. It's a bit fiddly. You know, putting the coils in is easy. The difficult part is wicking it properly so that you're getting a good flow of juice without flooding the chamber or cutting the juice off and getting dry hits. There we go. Right, we've got the cotton in, nice bit of resistance on the coil. So now we've got to do is trim it. I've got to trim the cotton with a confirmed scissors. There. Right. Basically, you've now got to give a haircut to the cotton. The way I describe it to people when they ask me how I wick an orchid is that you've basically got to give the cotton a mullet. So, sort of short and boofy on top with a long, thin tail trailing into the juice channel. Yeah, we're going for the Billy Ray Cyrus look. Don't break my heart, my achy breaky heart, just might not understand. Yeah, there we go. Alright, let's trim it. You see, I'm starting to get that little tail. You see that little tail? Bring it forward. Getting that little tail that's going to end up in the juice channel, but keep it nice and woofer up in the deck. Okay, trim the rest off. I mean, I love the Orchids. I've got the V1 and the V1.1, which were top filling. You had to unscrew them to fill them. The V4 has got the screw in the deck, very similar to the Cave one. Such a cracking vape. It's just, oh, the flavour production is brilliant from this deck. You know, and as I said, the only difficult part that really puts people off is setting up your cotton. You don't set your cotton up properly, you're not going to get it vaping properly. But I'll try and show you the best I can how I do it. It is fiddly, but it's worth it. Once you get it done, it is so worth it. I mean, for £18 from Vapour Boutique in Sheffield or Nottingham, it's a brilliant buy. Yeah, it's a fantastic buy. Now, the Orchid V1.1 that I have are their tobaccos, but this, I don't actually know. That's the box it came in. I don't actually know who made this. Comes in a lovely box, actually, a lovely presentation box. With spare screws, spare fill screws, spare O-rings for the tank, and a Phillips head screwdriver. Personally, I think I'd have preferred it if it was grub screws rather than Phillips heads. It does look a bit, yeah, with the Phillips. It'd be nice with the grub screws. Keep trimming it. Right. I'm getting this a little bit surely. Right. Get a little bit of juice on this so I can shape it properly. A little bit of juice. Just helps for me to feed it into the juice channels, and I can trim it a bit more so that I know that it'll wick properly up to the coils. This is Let's Vape 1.2 Snow Dog, by the way. It's a blue slush puppy flavour that Let's Vape 1.2 makes. Very nice, very lovely. Right, get this all wicked. Get trimmed. And you can see I'm sort of trimming it into the channels. That one's okay actually. Ooh, that's a bit messy. Alright, there we go. Let's have a look at that. Let's feed it into the channels.
perfect. Oh, that's a low one. There we go. So those two are really good. Feed that into the juice channel. So you've got those little spindly tails, but you're still quite full and fluffy at the top. You see that? So you've got the little cotton tails, going into the juice channels, but nice and fluffy up the top, feeding into the coils. There we go. You happy with that? And that's the Orchid V4. That's how I personally wick it with cotton, and I've not had an issue with it. Not an issue at all. So what we'll do is we'll get this put back together, filled up, and get a vape on it. Right, there we go. We're all filled up, and it is at 0.8 ohm resistance as we built. Looks really lovely in the golden box. The Pluminati juices, which can be bought from Vapour Boutique as well. but yeah, it's a brilliant. It's a tank. It's a dripper. It's great. Absolutely brilliant. Give it a quick toot. As you can see, cloud production is brilliant. Anyway, that's the build. That's the Orchid V4 from Vapour Boutique. About £18. I advise it. A brilliant buy. I mean, I've got the V1. I've got the V1.1. The V4. This is the mutts nuts. Absolutely brilliant. So, catch you in a minute. Okay then guys, we're back. Did the build for you. Vaping lovely. That was my wife's Orchid that I built. You can top fill them like the K-Fun. Yeah, or you can. I mean, there is a fill hole on the bottom for topping them up. Which is great. In this Orchid, I've currently got Clockwork Orange, also available from Vapour Boutique in Sheffield, Nottingham. It's a lovely juice. Look at sort of orange fizz, almost like an orangeade, like Fanta. It's lovely, and it's a good cloud producing, vapour producing juice. So, another quick toot. So, I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you found the build helpful. For those people that do fancy getting an Orchid version 3 or version 4, and it helps with the cotton, how to put the cotton in to give you that perfect amount of juice going to the coils. I mean, this, I've got a 0.5 ohm resistance build on this one. The one that I did was 0.8 for my wife, dual coil. This has got 0.4 millimeter canthal wire in it. And the other one I did was 28 gauge. So there you go. That's beautiful for a tank. Beautiful. Very nice. Absolutely gorgeous. Anyway. Hope you enjoyed that. I will be doing more videos at some point. I look forward to doing more and keeping in touch. And remember, watch Big Tom's reviews on YouTube. And if you want to join Big Tom and the Vaping Crew on Facebook, find the page and I'll put it in the annotations below for the Facebook page. But there you go. So, see you all later. See you.